guys, Andrew Watson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Today I have what is probably one of the most beautiful and easy chords to learn, and at the same time, it's really simple to apply. It's beautiful because you can create easy finger-picked ideas using it and very quickly make up your own songs from the shape, and it works on the guitar so incredibly simple that within minutes you'll be playing it and using it to create music. All around, it's a great concept and it's a lot of fun to work with. I also have a follow-up for this lesson over on my Patreon page, and that follow-up lesson is going to expand upon the ideas, taking things a little bit further with a couple of extra examples. So once you get all this stuff down, in the end, you're going to be able to use these ideas and make music with them. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. If you were to ask most guitar players to play an E minor chord, they'd probably play the open version of the chord, which is okay, it works in a lot of situations, but to switch over to another chord, especially if you're a beginner, you'd have to, you know, really revamp all your fingerings, completely change the way everything is set up to be able to move, let's say, from an E minor to a D major. However, If you used an easier way to work shapes along the neck, we could use a basic method that just highlights the chord tones that are most important. So I'm going to go to an E here, play an E root, and then I'm going to generate from that E a minor shape. And then to create a major in behind it as a D, it's super easy. It's very easy to relocate. It's just a lateral move. I could go down another whole step, play a C, and those are majors, minor. And making these shapes, you know, you can create songs really fast, really easy. I want to start off with teaching this to you by giving you a couple of major and minors. We're going to go off sixth string at first. I'm going to go off of an A here at the sixth string, fifth fret. And then on the fifth string, seventh fret, I'm going to add an E. And then up on the third string at the sixth fret, I'm going to place a C sharp. Now with A, E, and C sharp, I've got an A major shape. If I wanted to convert that A major over to A minor, all I do is take that C sharp and make it into a C natural. I'd have to bar with my index finger to generate the C natural there. But now I have A minor. It's just so simple to do this. And now I want to show you some shapes here that can function off of the fifth string as well. This is a very popular string to approach this method with. And we're going to start with an E major. And to do it, we're going to have an E note, and that's on the 5th string, 7th fret. And then I'm going to add here on the 4th string, on the 9th fret, I'm going to add in a B tone. And then up on top, I'm going to have a G sharp. It's on the 9th fret, a 2nd string. And that's an E major. If I want minor, all I got to do is drop that G sharp down to a G natural, and I've got E minor. So as you can tell, doing this is very, very easy. We're going to take a short break coming up in a minute here. I'm going to actually show you some nice ways of applying this. I've got some melodic examples I'm going to be going over with you. And on top of all this, if you join me later on my Patreon page, I'm going to be introducing you to some ways of adding suspended chords in and around these tones as well. So you're going to have a mix when you're done both of the lessons, both the YouTube lesson and the Patreon lesson. You'll have a mix of major, minor, and suspended chords covering both suspended second and suspended fourth. Once you learn these chords, they're really great because they're made up of all fretted notes, and there's only three notes to the whole shape, and they sit easily within a position. You know, they have that string skip, so they offer a little bit more, you know, width to the sound. And overall, they offer a simple fret hand technique for you too, so that makes them easy to play. They can be used laterally too, all along the neck, which is another bonus about these shapes for their application. And when you do that with anything, you build some really nice song parts that really take take advantage of the sound of the guitar, and that's a nice added benefit of a chord layout that allows us to very easily switch from major to minor, and these certainly adhere to that direction as well. Plus, on top of all that good stuff, these chords, you know, they're both easy to play and they're easy to move around, so when it comes to applying them, it's really simple. Now, let me show you just how nice these chords can sound when they get applied. I have a couple of examples for you, so let's jump right into them. All right, so we're going to go through this first exercise. It's in the key of E minor, and of course it's using the skipped string chords. We're going to set up our first shape here in the seventh position off of the E root fifth string. All of our shapes will be based on fifth string. The chord tones will go E to B, and then skipping the string, we'll have a G natural up top on the second string at the eighth fret. For the pluck, we're using our thumb, index, and ring finger to get that second string. So thumb and index are for fifth and fourth, and then ring finger for the second string. So after the E minor, we're going to jump down to the fifth position. We're going to do a D chord there, so we'll have D, A, and F sharp on the second string. So 5-7, and then a 7 on second string. Same plucking technique on the plucking hand. And then we're going to move over to second position, and we're going to set up a B minor there. So we'll have B, F sharp, and a D on second string. So frets 2, 4, and 3. And then we're going to move forward in the third position, and we'll have frets 3, 5, and then a 5 on top to get a C major chord. So altogether, we got E minor, D major, B minor, C major. And the plucking technique, again, thumb index on the fifth and fourth strings with the ring finger taking care of the second string. All right, so that's our first exercise. It's the E minor skipped string chord riff that I got for you. Let's move next to my second example for you. This one's in the key of G major. Check it out. Now for this one, we're setting up a series of chords that go toward the root chord of G major, and the chord changes are going to be D major, B minor, C major, into the G major root chord of the key center. Now to set up the plucking, you can tell it's a little bit different. On the last one, we were plucking everything together at once. Now with this new sound that's all based off the sixth string root, we're doing more of an arpeggiated effect. So we're getting like the sixth string into the fifth, and then we'll have the third string coming after that. The first chord layout is a D major, we're getting frets 10 and 12 on the fifth and sixth strings down there, and then we've sixth and fifth to be specific, and then we're getting the 11th fret, a third string coming in after, so that's the D, A, and the F sharp frets are 10, 12, and 11. And we're plucking individually, you know, kind of an eighth note feel, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, just like that. And then we're going to move into seventh position to get a minor chord off B next. So we're barring to get that across seventh fret, and the frets are going to be 7 and 9 on the sixth and fifth strings with the seventh fret of the third string up on the top there. And again, same plucking technique. We're going to move forward after that into eighth position. We'll get frets 8, 10, and 9 coming up afterwards. So we got a C note into a G and an E on top. That is what's making it major. And then we're going to move down and get another major pattern here in the third position with 3, 5, and 4. And that's a G and a D and a B note. All right, so you put it all together and you get this. So you can tell when you move these around the guitar, it's a really nice sound. I mean, it's very, you know, melodic. It's very laid back. You could, you know, even use it for one of those situations. If you've ever been in that situation where someone says, oh, hey, you play guitar, play me something. So you could just, you know, grab the guitar and do this stuff. It's very easy and it'd probably really impress them if they don't play. Now, the other side of this is we're right now using major and minor to go across these keys and set up these sounds. But what I want to do next with you in the Patreon lesson, because that's going to be the second half to this lesson plan. And in the Patreon lesson, I want to introduce suspended second and suspended fourth ideas. So that way, you're going to have a real mix of a lot of different directions that you're going to be able to take these string skipped ideas with these chord shapes that we're generating. And the chord shapes are very simple, you know, so all we're using is like the root and the third and the fifth. We alter the third to be able to create major and minor sounds out of them. And otherwise, you know, maybe the next thing that'll be a simple fix for going in different directions of color for you is going to be the addition of these suspended concepts. So I hope to see you next in the Patreon, and I hope you're a Patreon member already. If not, be sure to join up and start digging into all this stuff. All of the tab, the jam track of the piece you heard me play at the very beginning of the video lesson, all this stuff is going to be included for you in the Patreon download. So I hope to see you next on the Patreon lesson. Well, guys, if you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon supporters, which I hope you are, you're going to get to watch this lessons part two video where I'm going to introduce you to a fantastic sounding chord type to go along with the major and minor with these skipped string chord styles, and it is called suspended. You ain't going to want to miss this. It's going to be very cool. And along with the bonus video as a Patreon member, you'll also get some jam tracks and you'll get to download a detailed PDF handout. So head over to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Well, guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. Also, if you want to support my channel a little bit further, go and check out our Teespring store. The link to the Teespring shop is located in the pinned comment below in the comment section. And if you're looking for some great t-shirts, hats, bags, coffee cups, all with great guitar player designs on them, like I'm wearing right now with this t-shirt, go and check out our Teespring store. There's a ton of great merch in there, and it's really at great prices with fantastic products. Also, remember, if you are looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a chapter-by-chapter proven course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. We just rebuilt the website. It's full of a ton of free information. And if you sign up for a free membership, and you don't need a credit card or anything to sign up for that, you're going to get access to a whole bunch of free information that's extra bonus information that you can't get if you're just a visitor to the site. Also, if you do pull a free membership, you'll have access to a complete course called Quick Licks, and it is a fantastic program. You got to check it out. On top of that, there's a ton of courses. There's core curriculum courses like the beginner program, the intermediate, and the advanced, and there's a ton of electives as well, like the acoustic guitar program, guitar technique, guitar soloing, ear training, music reading. There's a ton of stuff. Go and check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to see all my videos here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. You will not be disappointed. There's a ton of great stuff here on YouTube for you. And aside from all that, I will be back later this week with another video, so I will see you then. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch up next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.